In the previous video, ChargerLAB tested the charging performance of the iPhone 16 series. The charging time of the four models is just over 2 hours. Under normal circumstances, the maximum power of the large size model is 30 watts, and the maximum power of the small size model is around 22 watts. Today, we use the iPhone 16 Pro as an example to test the charging process with 9 Apple chargers of different power to see what the difference is. This test took a very long time. The test was conducted in a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank. The data was recorded by PowerZ. Below, let's analyze them one by one. The Apple 5 watts charger has a voltage of 5 volts, a current of only 0.46 amps, and a power of 2.4 watts. It takes 7 hours and 16 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The Apple 10 watts charger has a maximum voltage of 5.3 volts, a maximum current of 1.4 amps, and a maximum power of 7.3 watts. The voltage slightly drops to 4.7 volts at 1 hour and 35 minutes, and then rises slowly. It takes 2 hours and 53 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The maximum power of the Apple 18 watts charger is 17.8 watts. The voltage is around 9 volts at first. The voltage dropped to 5 volts at 59 minutes. It takes 2 hours and 8 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The charging curve of the Apple 20 watts charger is similar to that of the 18 watts charger, with a maximum current of 2.1 amps and a maximum power of 19.5 watts. The voltage dropped from 9 volts to 5 volts at 57 minutes. It takes 2 hours and 6 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The Apple 30 watts charger has a maximum voltage of 15 volts, a maximum current of 1.4 amps, and a maximum power of 20 watts. The voltage dropped from 15 volts to 5 volts at 55 minutes. It takes 2 hours and 2 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The charging curve of the Apple 35 watts charger is similar to that of the 30 watts charger, with a maximum voltage of 15 volts, a maximum current of 1.4 amps, and a maximum power of 20 watts. The voltage dropped from 15 volts to 5 volts at 55 minutes. It takes 2 hours and 3 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The Apple 70 watts charger has a maximum voltage of 15 volts, a maximum current of 1.5 amps, and a maximum power of 23 watts. The voltage dropped from 15 volts to 5 volts at 55 minutes. It takes 2 hours and 4 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The maximum power of the Apple 96 watts charger is 30 watts. The voltage dropped from 15 volts to 5 volts at 56 minutes. It takes 2 hours and 3 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. The Apple 140 watts charger has a maximum voltage of 15 volts, a maximum current of 2.1 amps, and a maximum power of 32 watts. The voltage dropped from 15 volts to 5 volts at 59 minutes. It takes 1 hour and 59 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. Summarizing all the data in a line chart, it can be seen that the curves of 18 watts to 140 watts chargers are almost the same. The 5 watts and 10 watts chargers took 7 hours and 16 minutes, and 2 hours and 53 minutes respectively. In general, the 18 watts to 140 watts charger takes about 2 hours to fully charge the iPhone 16 Pro. These are all the tests of Apple's 9 chargers, 5 watts, 10 watts, 18 watts, 20 watts, 30 watts, 35 watts, 70 watts, 96 watts, and 140 watts. Except for the 5 watts and 10 watts chargers, the other curves are similar. This is because after the iPhone is replaced with a USB-C port, it cannot reach the older Apple 2.4 amp protocol, so the maximum power of the 5 watts and 10 watts chargers is only about 2 to 3 watts and 7.5 watts respectively. ChargerLAB recommends using chargers of 18 watts or above, and you can also turn on the optimized battery charging function to avoid overcharging. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.